Okay, this recording onwards will be available. Okay.
Okay.
Cannot, Sriram cannot understand, no? Jairam. Okay, now you start a fresh recording. Let us take up the most important organ in our body. What is the most important organ in our body?
Brain.
Not the tongue. Huh? Eat. Heart has to keep pumping. Huh? The heart is important. Heart is the power engine. The brain is what helps you to focus. It's a computer. Right? Brain is the focus.
CPU.
Very good. Okay. So let us understand our brain. Do you know how much do you know about your brain? Anybody here? How much you know about your brain?
I know the functions.
You know the functions. What are the functions of brain?
Brain gives information to the nerves, to all the parts of the body.
Control. I'll teach you more how to use the brain powerfully. You know how to use the program computer? All of you are computer programming? You know how? You don't know computer program?
But I know.
You know how to use the brain?
How to use the computer?
The problem is, we know how to use the computer, but we don't know how to use the brain. Computer programming is how to make the computer work. Next classes, few classes, I'll teach you how to make this computer work properly. The brain computer. Brain is the fastest computer, right? We have two parts in the brain, left brain and right brain. Okay? Right? You know that?
Yeah.
What are the functions of left brain and right brain? Anybody?
Left brain controls the right side of the body, right side of the brain controls the left.
Okay, very good. So there are two parts of brain. Left brain controls the right side of the body, right brain controls the left side of the body. Is it correct? How to use your brain properly is the question. Are you using your brain properly?
No, one side.
How much part of the brain you are using, people are using? 7%. What? 95%? What are you doing? Waste. Okay. How much percentage of the brain you are using?
I use
99%. Actually, you are using 5%. If you use 99%, you are a Superman. Okay? No, you are using all the time. It doesn't mean using.
I don't know how much brain I use.
Okay, correct. Right now, you are able to use only small power of the brain. Okay? And if you are able to use 10%, you will become a super. Huh? And if you use 20%, you will become like Vivekananda. Understand?
Using 20%?
Yes, 100% is very, very powerful. 100% is Superman. Okay? So we have to learn how to use our brain in a better way. Is this correct? Clear? You have the ability to use the brain. Next, you should understand how I'm able to use my brain properly. In next few classes, in each class, I will tell you how to use the brain properly, step by step. Today I'll give you introduction. But you have to apply in your life. Okay? You understand? So we have a left side and right side. Is it clear? Right part of the brain, okay, is expressions. What is the expression? Imagination. Okay, for example, close your eyes. And imagine what I'm saying. Okay. Imagine that you are going in a park. A beautiful park. The birds are singing. You can hear the music. Okay. And there's so much of peace and silence there. And you can see, you can get the smell of flowers. Nice smell of flowers. You can hear the birds chirping. You can hear a river flowing nearby. You can hear a dog barking. See a butterfly. How colorful is the butterfly? See how many colors you can see in the butterfly. Just feel the smell of flowers. You are feeling the breeze, the cold breeze is touching you. You are feeling very relaxed and wonderful. Feeling very peaceful. Now slowly come back to the place where you are sitting. Open your eyes. How many people are able to visualize? Can you raise your hands? Okay. Tell me what are the colors are in the butterfly. Did you see properly? Very nice. Wonderful. Okay. Did you smell?
Flower.
Huh?
Yeah, I smell a bit.
Which flower?
I think sunflower.
Sunflower has a smell?
I think jasmine.
Jasmine. Okay, very good. What did you see? What color of the trees? What trees were there? Imagination should be sharp and clear. What did you see? Huh? Yeah, you saw what? No, what did you see? Explain to me, no? Describe.
The morning, like sky blue, and then the sun was shining. Then there's a pathway.
There's a pathway.
With leaf falling.
Leaf falling.
The trees with, I don't know which tree was it, but it's
very good.
Many trees, and then
Shri Ram.
Was a big path.
Mm-hmm.
And at the entrance there was a arch.
Mm.
And there was a pathway in
there. Right.
And inside the pathway there was a big garden kind of thing.
Mm.
Many colored flowers.
Okay, very good.
And, you know,
very good.
And the bridge.
Okay. Very nice. What was the color of the bridge? What are the shape of the bridge? Arch. Okay, very good. Shri Ram? Jai Ram? Did you visualize clearly? Describe what did you visualize.
The path was quite big. The leaves were falling apart. There was a dog barking.
Then what was the color of the butterfly? I told there's a butterfly flying. Didn't notice? You should know. Okay. Now come to you.
The water is flowing very fast.
You heard the sound of the water? Very good. Then what else did you see? Very good. Very good. Okay, very good. Now, what did I ask you? Okay, tell me.
So, I saw these flowers. I saw these flowers beside the park.
What color was the flower?
Purple. And I saw the trees and the moon lawn.
Lawn was there in the forest. Okay, park. I said forest or park?
Park,
okay, not the forest.
It is afternoon.
Very good. Very good. So, did I ask you? Okay, then what else did you notice?
The river was flowing. Mm. On the side of the river, there was nothing. It was just plain green.
Mm.
I was walking under the shade of the trees. There was some cold wind.
Mm.
It was hot.
What dress you are wearing?
It was like I was seen from my eyes.
Okay, you didn't see what you want.
No, I was looking
for. Are you sure you are wearing dress? Okay.
Yeah, it was really hot. It was cold breeze.
Mm.
I could smell out. When rain falls on the mud, that smell, I could smell it.
Very good.
And then there was some red and orange cloud.
Very good.
Here.
Did you hear any sounds?
I heard lot of birds.
Birds, okay, very good.
Like the morning birds.
Morning birds. Morning bird has a different sound?
Morning birds are usually not there in the evening.
Okay.
Or sometimes in the afternoon.
Very good. Okay.
But
what about
usually it is afternoon, but they're morning birds.
Oh, very good. What about Charan?
Prabhuji, I was beside my school, which has a lot of trees.
Huh.
I was walking and I was able to hear bees humming. I saw a butterfly which was yellow in color, which was going, mm-hmm. which was going around, and also, I could hear a dog barking, which is the dog was barking from my school neighbors.
There are girls in the park,
Prabhuji.
There are girls in the park. You didn't notice?
No.
You can tell frankly, I know what you saw. Okay. Then what did you notice? What else did you notice?
Yeah, that's all. I noticed trees. Ashoka, near my school, there were Ashoka trees.
Okay.
Ashoka and Banyan. Exactly.
Okay, very good. Okay. So, now what you have done, you have used one muscle of your brain. One muscle. Right? Body has so many muscles. Correct? See, you have seen that bodybuilders, right? Or that, what you call? Six abs. Eight abs, huh? So they have a strong muscle man is there, right? So many muscles are there. They go to gym and every day exercise like this. Correct? So the brain has muscles. Just now you use one of the muscles of the brain. What? Just one muscle is this much. Now, how strong is your muscle? Like the weight lifter, the muscle is strong, they lift a lot of weight. If the brain muscle becomes strong, your imagination will be very powerful. Did you understand? So now if I want to give a mark, out of 100, okay, how much mark will you give for your brain muscle? Out of 100, let's say 100 out of 100. How clear is your imagination? Okay, how much mark you want to give and how much improvement you can do? Sriram? 45, you're so accurate. Huh?
90.
Is your imagination very clear? The imagination has 5 aspects. Okay, what are the 5 aspects for us? Touch, sound, smell, taste, and what else? Seeing. The 5 things you should see, be able to use very properly and clearly. Then the muscle is very strong. Did you taste something there in the park? Huh?
From the apple tree, I tasted apple.
Did you? Are you telling now or when you imagined it's there?
I imagined.
When you imagined you tasted apple, you didn't tell me. There was no apple tree there when you told me?
Yes, butterfly.
Okay, fine. So, how big was the apple? Very good. So, if you want to give a mark to your imagination, Okay, how much will you give? 65. So clear. So clear.
I'll give 70.
You'll give 70? Okay. That kid. He is accurate. 37. Okay. Shriram, Jairam. Just pass. Why 35? Why not more 40? Because you have to imagine very clearly. Understand? Very detailed, clear. Are you clear? Understand? So how much you will give? Sri Charan?
Prabhuji, 50 based on the constraints.
50 based on the constraint. What is the constraint? What was the constraint?
Taste. I didn't taste anything.
Okay. So
to a bit smell. Yeah.
Now exercise for all of you. Okay. Make your imagination muscle strong. How do you imagine, make your imagination muscle strong? By all the five details you have to imagine. Taste, touch, smell, sound, right? You have to take some, imagine perfectly clear imagination outcome. If you do that, all the five, okay? Then next class, from whatever marks you are told, you have to do, you show me improvement, right? Just like people go to gym every day, dum, dum, lift, weight, and they keep increasing weight. So like that, your imagination you have to make sharper and sharper and sharper and sharper. Right? What is your imagination quality? HD and that, what is there? 4K, 8K. What is your imagination quality? Okay. Hey, very powerful meditators. Okay. There they can imagine in 4K. The tray, 4K means where the TV is there, no? My TV, if the full picture comes, it very, very clear in colors, all colors. Very sharp, clear clarity they imagine. Right? So can you train your brain better for imagination? And you have to tell me what exercise you did and what is the result you get. And how do you measure your result also, you have to tell me. Are you clear? Are you clear? Yes, you increase your percentage of brain ability. Each muscle of the brain will take up training. Right? So this whole class is to make you people better. Okay? You understand? All of you understood? Okay? So you find out. Now next time I'll ask you the question. How did you train your brain? What result you got? How much mark you got? How are you improving? So every day, little bit training you have to give so that your clarity becomes more and more. Okay? I'll tell you how people train. How people train the imagination muscle. There are Buddhist monks. Okay? They train your imagination. They create a bigger mandala. Mandala means rangoli. You know rangoli? Rangoli? A big rangoli. A huge, the rangoli will be, you just check Kala Chakra Mandala in any of the internet you check. Okay, I'll just show you Kala Chakra Mandala, how it is. Can I show, for project like Gayatri?
I can share.
I have to stop this?
Somebody sharing,
okay. No, what you see on this is different. Okay. See, these are some of the Kala Chakra mandalas. Wait.
He's sharing the PPT.
You are able to see that?
Come here and then see. Now, ask if Charan can see this.
Charan, can you see this? Charan? You can see it. Charan, are you able to hear me?
Yes, Prabhuji. Yes, yes.
See, this mandala, it looks very small here, okay? Right? This mandala will be looking very small. And each mandala, each portion, if you can blow up, each small thing you can blow up. It is like consists of so many devatas, so many cities, everything is there. It's like a map of how the heaven is there, how devatas are there, all those things. And each to mandala to make, it will take 6 months. It is made out of sand, rangoli. Okay. There'll be some 200 monks will be working to make this. And they will not have a paper. All these things are imagined. They remember everything, every single detail. Even including the dress which the devata wears, the city where they wear, the gate, everything detail they remember. Okay? They will remember the type of dress where the devatas wear. Okay? Every single detail is remembered. You understand how sharp it will be? And each will have a color. That color only has to be used. So you can imagine how much memory training they would have done. Right? You understand, Sri Charan?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Jairam, you understood? What about you, Kritik? So that's the amount of training they do. And women do rangoli at home, you know? Okay? The rangoli is a memory training for memory training. Women can produce the rangoli from memory. Beautiful colors, beautiful patterns. That's a memory training. Are you clear? So, did you understand, Shiva? Did you understand? Now, it is 3D, 4D, 3D, 4D, 3D. Yeah. So, stone 3D, right? So people imagine 3D. An artist, my daughter Katyayani, she can imagine everything very clearly in mind. This one.
She imagines.
And she can imagine all the lines and all. So you can train your imagination to be powerful. Are we clear? Do you want?
This is not taught in the class.
This is not taught in the
class. Not all your school. It's only the left brain which is taught. Now, what you have completely right brain, I have never thought it can do this.
Okay. So, is this clear to all? Now, have you used your muscle of this brain very powerfully, properly? So, did you know that there is a muscle exist there? Muscle of imagination, you know. How to make the muscle stronger, did you know? Okay, so next assignment for you people, next this thing, you have to train this muscle, okay? And that's not something, you have to show me the proof that you have trained. I need a proof. How do you produce the proof? I don't know. I don't want to, don't know, I trained. For all you know, you may be sleeping. Okay?
How is it?
You find out how you prove. Because you imagine, how do you prove? That's your imagination. You have to prove to Prabhuji that I have trained my muscle, my brain, for better imagination. How do you prove that? 100%. Not 100% is difficult. So, you have to show that you have worked on your brain muscle and you have made your imagination better. Can you do that? You have to prove. How do you prove? You have to think. You have to imagine how to prove. Okay, he has already found a solution. But that has to come from imagination. And it should be sharp. Correct? Now, how do you prove in the drawing? Drawing is only 2D. So I am speaking of 5D. What are the 5D? How many are there in 5D? No. Touch. smell, sound, taste, and vision, and three-dimensional space. How many dimensions is that? Eight D. Okay. So now it is very difficult to start with the 8D. You tell me how many Ds you want to start.
What's D?
Dimension. See, this is on paper, if you write, it's two dimension, right? If you use the color, it's paper, flat. But if you build a building, it's three dimension. Then you have to add the color, sound, taste, smell, and what else? Touch. In the imagination. Okay. Don't take very hard task, but whatever you do, you should be able to prove me that you have done improvement. Is the exercise for you? Are you clear? Jaira, will you try? How will you try? You work on that. Okay. So our Puranas, okay, Puranas, Vaikuntha Loka and Kailas Loka is a training for people in memory. In meditation, they used to visualize every single aspect of that. Okay, how do you enter Vaikuntha Loka? What gate you go through? Who will meet? All this is training. Their imagination they make perfect. Right now, you people are spoiling your imagination, thinking of worrying about life. This will happen. You are using your imagination, but in a wrong way. Okay. Right way of imagination is creative imagination, which will improve your life. There are people who visualized. Our Puranas are for visualization. Oh, Vishnu is sitting like this. Yes, this Kirita, this Abharana, Lakshmi is sitting like this. All these are imagination. Now please tell me, what are you using your imagination for? Where has your imagination gone? Chanka Chakra Gara Padma. That's not that. Not only this, that. This mantra is there, no? Keshavaya Namaha Nara. Keshava, Narayana, Madhava, Madhusudana, Trivikrama, Vamana, Sridhara, okay? Shashikesha, there are 24 names of God. Achyutam, Keshavam, Raman, Damodaram, 24 names are there, okay? Now, the people who used to do Sandhya Vandana or meditation, they will visualize that form of God very clearly, including the dress they wear. Okay, and these are actually, there are four arms. Okay, in each forearm, the difference between each devata is Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma. Okay, in next devata, Vasudeva, Chakra, Gada, Padma, Shankha. Like that, permutation combination will be there. Okay, you understand what I'm saying? Not only the type of weapon they wear, the dress, the Abharana, and with that they used to do puja mentally. You should imagine how clarity there, how much clarity have. Understand? These are our ancestors didn't do just like that. Any mantra, any puja is brain has to be completely left brain, right brain. Left brain, right brain has to be completely exercised. You have to get fully involved. Visualization of shilpis. But the mantras are there, no? Mantras and vigrahas are there. They are not just this thing. You have to imagine that, then your brain improves the visualization, and your wrong thinking will go. It will be replaced with the creative thinking, beautiful divine thinking. And they will visualize very clear details, not just rough sketch. Okay? So exercise is understood to all the people? Okay.
So you may be doing it in your class already. If somebody gives a craft to your class, you are creating a craft. You are imagining some craft inside, and then you pass it. So now the new exercise is you completely imagine the entire craft. Then you do it. So when somebody builds a house, an engineer builds a house, he imagines the house inside first. Then he will put the plan. Right? So he creates once here and once he actually does it. So when you have a task to do, you need to imagine the task, complete task. How will I do the task? So we'll come to that next, right after, you know.
Okay. Is this clear? The exercise is clear to all of you? And you have to work on your muscle. Imagination muscle. Improve it and tell me, prove that you are done. This is clear. Okay. So now I'll just quickly run through here and I'll take next couple of classes, I'll take only brain. Okay. So then, right. Skin is not there.
No.
Okay. So the brain has other functions. Your right brain has imagination, which is very powerful. Okay. Then emotional intelligence. What is emotional intelligence? Emotions. Anger, fear, right? Then jealousy, love. All those things come from the right brain. So tell me, please raise your hand. How many people are angry? Get angry in life? Okay. So anger comes, or you're switching on and switching off anger? You get angry, but you get anger when you want, or it just comes? Sometimes you get it also? You make it happen?
I don't make it happen. Sometimes it only comes.
So it only comes means, is brain under your control or you are under the control of brain?
I'm under the control.
But you should control the brain now. Huh? Understand? Anger comes, or you want to, you bring the anger?
Anger comes. Sometimes if you want to, in my school, if I need to tell children something, they're not listening.
You get angry and you pretend angry. There is the difference. So which is preferable? So the emotional center should be under our control. How to learn that emotional thing? I'll teach you. Okay. Next, it will take some time. First, the imagination. Then expression. Okay. We express something in life. Smile. Anger. Sadness. And music. All these are expressions. Music, art is expression. Okay. So, each of them we'll take up one by one, slowly. Then, this is on the right side. Left side is language. How many languages people can speak here? Speak, read, write. Who is the maximum? How many languages you can speak? Three. Four. How many? Any more than three? Four or five. Sanskrit, English, Hindi, Kannada, Konkani. My wife can add Tamil. Okay. All these are languages.
I know four, but
Hindi bit. Very good. So the language improves our brain capacity. Left side. Left. That's why Indians do perform better, because Indians by birth, they are exposed to three or four languages. Americans and all, they are exposed to only one language, English. So Indians have better language ability. Because better language, they have better brain also. Okay. So then comes the left side is numbers, mathematics, science, technology. Okay. Then analysis, ability to analyze logically. These are comes from the left side. So your schooling system is working on the left side in the school. So here we start working on the right side. Then we do the balancing, like wheel balancing. Okay, understand? The purpose is to make you use your brain better. As you use the brain better, you become more powerful, more, okay? Are you clear? So the exercise for you this week, exercise for you, I've told. And whatever you do, please keep posting in the group. And better post it as a video, not as a, right? You say, I did this exercise, this is the result, you can keep posting. Is it clear to all? So that it can shared. And I am only replying, no, you people should reply. If Namit has sent something, did you read it? Then you have to say what is good about it. You have to comment on that. What did he do? All those things. It's you people have to interact. It's not that I do the clapping and Namit where he did or Sriram where he did. No, you people should read and you should give a feedback to Namit. When you do, you should do. Other people should give feedback. Is it clear to Sri Charan?
Yes, probably. Yes.
It is not a passive, it's not a tamasha which goes on here. It's a lot of interactions. I want you people to interact. I want you people to criticize also. If somebody is not doing fine, criticize so that it helps him to improve. Don't criticize means make it harsh. Help him to improve so that all of us become better. If we don't contribute, we don't become better. Is it clear? Understand? In the concert board?
Leadership.
Yeah.
So this whole leadership.
Leadership.
See, IQ is left brain. IQ. Okay. IQ is a left brain. Michael. IQ is a left brain.
Shri Chan, are you able to hear?
No, Prabhuji.
Shri Charan?
No, Prabhuji. I cannot hear.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Prabhuji.
And what?
Shri Charan can hear. This is Venkat. Can you hear?
Yes. Now I can hear you. Yeah.
Yes. What I'm saying is, IQ is left brain. EQ is right brain.
Yeah.
It's something called social quotient, SQ.
SQ.
So when you comment each other, when you sort of understand each other, okay, when you start networking with each other, you're already doing it, okay, with others in your. So if you can network, it will become social quotient, okay? Then you are exposed to adverse situations. It's called adversity quotient.
Adversity quotient.
There are four quotients actually. So when you become leader, you know, even though your IQ is not big, if my EQ, SQ is better, I can rule others. I can deploy many people with IQ. I still manage them. I'll get the work done. So, SQ overrides your EQ also, IQ also. So, if your SQ is good, you can rule almost everybody. Okay, so AQ is a little interesting. You can survive in any situation. Adversity quotient. So try to move from IQ to EQ, EQ to SQ. SQ, EQ is an emotional quotient. SQ is a social quotient. So this nobody tells you, okay? When you move to SQ, you can become the best leader.
And there is one more SQ. It's called spirituality quotient. Okay. So IQ, we are not focusing here. IQ is your school. EQ, SQ, SQ, square Q. Social quotient and spiritual quotient. And emotional quotient is what we are focusing here. Quotient means improvement of that. Okay. So the assignment for you, each of you, is next 1 month you have to interact on that WhatsApp, and you have to help each other to improve. You have to help. You have to make other people, everybody to help each other improve. The more you make others help improve, the more you better you become. Okay, so this is the assignment, right? So now today, this month of 18th, this month assignment is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Have you heard of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa?
Yeah.
Okay, what did you hear of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? Very good. Then what did you hear? What else? Anybody? Sri Charan?
Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. It
was what?
Prabhuji?
Sorry?
I heard few stories of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, but I don't remember them.
Okay. Next.
I know one story that he worshipped every woman as a sister.
Okay, very good. Next 1 month assignment for each of you is study the life of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Okay?
Teachings,
life. Okay. So the categories are three. One is inspiration. What inspires you about Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? What is inspiration about Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? So what is the message of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa? Okay. Then third is, how you can apply in your life. Can somebody repeat what I said?
Inspiration from
Then
how you can apply it in your life. And then
his life.
What
message? Message, inspiration. So that you make into acronym. What is the acronym? AIM. AIM, AM. Okay. You have to work on three projects, not one project. AM project. Okay. You didn't come last month, right? You have six projects.
Projects.
Okay. So Vivekananda and Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. And who didn't do the project last month? Charan?
Yes, Prabhuji, I didn't do.
So you did?
I didn't do.
You have six projects to complete. And six are video projects. Video each. It is 30 minutes video.
Okay.
Five minutes separate.
Okay.
And for others assignment, when Charan posts 5 minutes video, you have to give him feedback so that he will improve. Or you have to give a comment, or you have to tell what you have learned. Are we clear? Is it something usable? I mean, useful? What I'm teaching, what I'm telling you people?
Yes, probably.
Like doing that? As he smiles. Okay. So why you don't like? You have to tell. No. I'm fine. It's not important. No. In life, always, yes, I want to do. It helps me. Right? That is inspiration. I will do. Okay, I will do. Because you tell. I have no choice. Okay? So that's not the way. Is this important for you? Will it help you? Does it help you? How will it help you? So always you have to see how it helps me in life. Okay. Don't do anything because somebody told you. What about you? Does it help you? How? Okay. So bring a clarity, confidence. We learn from great personalities. We'll take businessmen, scientists, which of them we'll take. But one by one we learn. So then a lot of things we can learn in life. Right? Are we clear? So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is our next month's project. And those who are not completed, the projects will keep on increasing. Okay. So now your Ramakrishna Paramahamsa project is there and the imagination project is there. Imagination project, how many videos will make? Please tell me. How I am improving imagination? Of course you have to tell. No, you can can ask your father also. You can ask anybody, no? You can go and teach her. Please, I want to imagine something. Please tell me. That also is imagination. No? You can find any places, no? Correct? So, but you have to do experiment projects. So for this, you have two projects to do. Two videos you have to prepare. 5 minutes each. How you are working and what is the result? It is like all are like scientists. Experiment. You should do experiment and see how it works or not. Are you clear? We are not spirituality. It is a science experiment. Okay. Are you clear? How many projects you have to do for next month?
Three
plus two. Three on Ramakrishna Paramahamsa's life. Two on?
Imagination.
5 projects you have to do. 5 projects of 5 minutes each. And then you have to give feedback to others. Done? Is it too heavy? Okay. If it's heavy, tell me. Now this is my project. Now he'll give next week.
I'll give you. What I'm going to tell you will help you.
Okay.
Getting things done is.
Okay. So done? Okay. Now I'll tell Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Okay. Let us chant mantra of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्म स्वरूपिणे स्थापकाय च धर्मस्य सर्वधर्म स्वरूपिणे अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः. Now use your imagination. Okay, imagine that Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is standing in front of you and he is blessing you. Avatar Varishtaya Ramakrishnaya Te Namaha. Avatar Varishtaya Ramakrishnaya Te Namaha. Avatar वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः. Okay, so I'll tell you the meaning of this and why. Okay, I told you about imagination, right? The imagination can be used in a very powerful way. Okay, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa imagined Mother Kali. Okay, he imagined, and his imagination was so strong, okay, that Mother Kali appeared in front of him and she took food from him. So you can, your imagination can be made so powerful that you can make God come in front of you and talk
visibly.
Okay, so now you tell me how much imagination is powerful for you, how many marks you can give. No, if your imagination is make God stand in front of you, this 100. So can you imagine making God stand in front of you and talk to you fully like a person?
We need to see God, we should meditate for 10,000.
No, you should have powerful imagination, not meditate for 10,000 years. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa imagination is 100. 100 marks. So he can imagine and she stands in front of him fully. Oh. Do you understand? So
full body?
Completely. And she takes food from his hand. He can touch her. He can talk to her. And that will happen. Your imagination becomes completely clear. That's 100 marks. Now you decide where are you.
Some other people see with Swami Vivekananda.
No, because their imaginations. There is the 0 marks. So if imagination becomes powerful, completely you can make God stand in front of you and talk. Understand? It's not 10,000 years. It's the mind. Are you clear? Okay. So I'll tell you about Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. This sloka says avatara varishtaya. You know what is avatar? Who is avatar? Avatar, who is, what is the meaning of avatar?
Incarnation.
So God takes the human form like Rama, Krishna, okay, and various divine incarnations to help people, to guide people. But he doesn't do very often. Why? Only when major changes are required in the earth. Major changes. Okay. So you people know names of avatars, incarnations? Tell me. Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana, Parashurama, Shri Rama, Krishna, Buddha. And next avatar is not yet happened, Kalki. Okay, these are all major events. There is one thing which you did you notice? Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha, Vamana. No, from fish to amphibian to animal and man to a short man. Our ancestor, the God came as incarnation, as an evolution also. You heard of Darwin's evolution, right? What did he say? That evolution started in water, then amphibian, then animals, you said, right? So that our ancestors said much, much before. 10,000 years before said, evolution has happened like this. That's avatar. Okay? So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa is avatar, incarnation. What avatar is that? Why is he took avatar? So people, what happened? Indians had lost confidence in themselves. Okay? The Muslim invasion and the British rule. In that, Indians had forgotten their dharma. Okay? They didn't know how to find God. They thought finding God is imaginary, not real. God is not imaginary. God is real. Okay, all our Puranas, what, everything is real, not imaginary. So we think God is imaginary. That's not true. God is real. But people lost the confidence. If you don't have confidence, you can't find. Okay? To bring the confidence to the Indians, to bring the confidence to the society, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa took incarnation. What incarnation? Incarnation. He took and he did various spiritual practices and realized God in many ways. In all
religions.
And all religions also. So that I said, you can realize God in all religions. People don't know that they can realize God. So all religions are related to God relation. So everybody, all of us human beings should be loving each other. We should not fight with each other. That's what he taught. Okay. He realized God as, first he realized God as Mother Kali. How much realization? When he calls Amma, Kali will come. Oh. Then he gives food, she will eat. No, there were people before people seen, but in the last century, first person. Earlier, all Prahlada and all have seen God. Prahlada, Dhruva, you heard of their stories? Okay, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa in the last century, first person.
19th century.
So he came there to Indians to tell that Mother Kali can be seen. Any god can be seen. Okay, it's not imagination. Right? You can talk to God. You can get blessing from God directly. So that was a tremendous change in the mind of people. Oh, it's possible. Then they lost confidence. They thought all these gods are imaginary, not real. But your imagination now is wrongly working. That's why you're not able to see God. Okay? You have to be able to channelize your imagination perfectly. So that's what he did. He did puja of Kali and he chants. What did he chant? Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma
Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe. Can you visualize mother coming in front of you and talking, standing in front of you? Divine Mother. Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma
Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai
Jai Ma.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Jai Ma.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Jai Ma.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Ma Ambe.
Jai Jai Ma.
Then
Mother Kali used to come and take food from his hand. Okay, so that was his greatness. Then he brought he taught to Vivekananda, and Vivekananda brought, last month I told how Vivekananda brought confidence in the Indians. Right?
Closing eyes or opening eyes?
You can see both closed and open eyes, both. No, actually when Mother Kali comes, he'll open his eyes. It's not just imagination. She'll stand in front of him. And that Mother Kali statue used to be there in temple. Okay? When he chants Jai Ma Ambe, the stone statue used to breathe. Then he'll go and check up. Is she really breathing or not? So that is the power of devotion, bhakti.
He was big or small?
He was 25, 30 years.
Such a small age.
Ah. Okay. So then what happened?
Was Vivekananda born?
No, at that time, no. Vivekananda came later. Vivekananda probably would have born a young kid that time. Okay. So what happened? Ramakrishna Paramahamsa's greatness is he worshipped Kali and realized Kali. Then he taught the world that yes, and he did only 64 plus. He realized Sri Ramachandra. Okay, for realizing Sri Ramachandra, he did sadhana or meditation as how Hanuman will do. It's called Hanuman Bhava Sadhana. Okay, Hanuman realized Rama, no? Like that, he realized Rama. Okay, Rama came to him. And for realizing Hanuman, like Hanuman Sadhana, what he did, he thought Hanuman is sitting inside me, and how Hanuman will do. He sat on the tree, ate fruits on the tree, and thought of Rama, 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 and Rama came. Okay, imagine to realize God, you can use your imagination to make science powerful, science and technology. Anything you can do, but your imagination to be strong, perfect, noise free. Then he imagined this Sita Mata. Sita Mata is sitting inside him and calling Rama. Then Rama, Rama, Rama. Then Rama came. Then he visualized Krishna, like Yashoda, Mother Yashoda. Then Krishna came. Okay. Then he thought, I'll call Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came. Then I thought of Allah, Allahu Akbar. He realized Allah. Okay. Then there are 64 different types of sadhanas, 64 different tantra sadhanas, tantra. There are different techniques of...
In the photo are like visible.
Visible. Jesus comes and merges with him. Okay. Then he did 64 different types of sadhana. They're called tantra sadhana. These are all sadhanas on one side. Then there are sadhana called tantra. Tantra means they are actually sadhanas are there for people who have negative impressions also, or different type of thinking. So they do sadhana in the smashana, where dead bodies are there, because you have to drop the fear. So sit in the smashana, dead body, near dead body, and meditate. Like that, he did all types of sadhana. About 69 times ways he realized God. Nobody on the earth has done that much. Okay? Rather only one type. Okay? So, then one day, Totapuri, a guru came called Totapuri came. Totapuri taught him Atmadnana, self-realization. What is self-realization? To realize that I am pure consciousness, Shiva. Okay? What is that? Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Manabuddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivananani. Shivoham. 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 So the assignment for you people, you complete Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. I just only told sample. Okay, now you have to find out on that. So let us close for my session. I'll close and Venkatji will take.
You want to take 5 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Let yourself and then we'll come back. Stand up, go around. So we'll take 5 minute break. You want